make this city a viable, going, great city that it can be and has been, and I'm sure will be in the future.
To truly know a city, we must know who believes in it, who invests in it, who has a stake in its future. This is Detroit. It is a city where something quite remarkable is taking place, something unique in the history of cities. For here on these 33 acres of riverfront property, 51 of the leading companies in America have made an investment, have expressed confidence that Detroit is a going concern, a vital center in which to live and conduct business. Privately financed urban development in history and is more than an example of local boosterism. Its owners have made a business investment and they expect a reasonable return. They have chosen Detroit because they believe in its renaissance, its rebirth. They're concerned not with its past, but with its potential. And they have placed their faith in a multi-million dollar dream called Renaissance Center. When it is finished, there will be nothing quite like it in all the world. City of some interesting contrasts. First, when Detroiters look across the river at Canada, they're looking south. Detroit is a Midwestern city, yet it ranks as one of America's busiest ports. From here you can sail to northern Canada, or New York, or Singapore. Then there's its nickname, the Motor City. But only 13% of Detroit's workforce is employed by the automakers. The rest work for a host of non-automotive organizations. Detroit is almost synonymous with mass production and automation, and it can build almost anything you care to imagine. But it is also the fourth largest financial center in the world. It has been called an industrial town, yet there are 31 colleges and universities, and 41 business, trade, and technical schools in the area. Its pace and tempo are like that of any great city. But an hour away, 400 lakes and streams, and all manner of recreation. From the air, Detroit is a wheel, with great ribbons of concrete radiating from its hub. At its heart, Cobo Hall, one of the world's largest exhibit arenas. The Ford Auditorium, home of the Detroit Symphony. The Windsor Tunnel to Canada. And Renaissance Center. The project was designed by John Portman, whose Peachtree Center did much to revitalize downtown Atlanta. Embarcadero Center in San Francisco is another of Portman's innovations. The man is far more than an architect, for his designs aspire to no less a goal than lifting the human spirit. He uses open, soaring space, several visible levels, color, texture, light, and even sound to touch and delight our senses. Renaissance Center, five giant towers rise from a multi-level podium. The podium itself is a full-scale 350,000 square foot shopping center with retail shops, cafes, restaurants, banks, brokerage firms, theaters, private clubs, and a department store. At the corners of the podium, four 39-story office towers, each served by high-speed elevators on the outside of the building. They'll contain 2 million square feet of office space, tenants will lease individual offices or a complete floor or even several floors. At the center of the complex, the Detroit Plaza, the world's tallest hotel. With more than 1,400 guest rooms and a huge exhibit hall, the Plaza contains all the services, comforts, and activities one would expect from a great hotel. But just to enter this building can take your breath away. The lobby covers more than an acre and rises six stories indoors. Five levels of suspended pedestrian walkways cross an atrium. At its core, a reflecting pool surrounds a circle lounge, a revolving cocktail island that seems to float on the water surface. And everywhere you look, a visual feast. The Detroit Plaza will house 11 restaurants, but none quite like the Sundial, which crowns the hotel 700 feet above the city. It is reached by way of a glass-enclosed high-speed elevator, again on the outside of the building. Two of the Sundial's three levels revolve 360 degrees. You sit in your chair and watch the city, 70 stories below, turning, changing before your eyes. Each minute, a new, fresh perspective of Detroit. A city reborn. Renaissance Center may well be the architectural achievement of this decade. It is a total environment, a town within a great city, linked by rail, waterway, superhighway, and air to the other cities of the world. Renaissance Center is 51 of the nation's leading companies joined in a partnership and in an affirmation. For in building these towers, they are saying that great cities like Detroit are the essential source of our vitality as a people. To be a part of this center, to work here, to visit, to shop, or only to experience its ambience, can enrich our vision of society and of ourselves.